you have seen me in another video. You have seen me use paper staplers to tackle paintbrush skeleton pieces to each other. But this is going to be a very heavy jumbo size paintbrush. So I don't want to take any chances, because the head of the paintbrush is fed up with now, but when it's full of paint, I'm sure that thing can easily drink a pint of paint. So I make sure I put some really stable staples to hold this paintbrush together. There we go. I must be sure that thing can take the load, because there will be a load. Now, we insert it. Okay, once again. If you want it to look nice, if you just want it to be done, you can just open the stapler completely and staple in. If you want it to look nice, you open, then close the stapler. I hope it will reach that point where it inserts the staple. And that way you can control the alignment of the staples. And also make it look better in the process. However, as mentioned before, for paintbrush that size, or for any size, even the small ones, you have to make sure you add enough staples. There's no question about it, because you don't want a wet paintbrush to detach from the handle. That will be a big mess. So that for this reason, I'm going to staple this one with the heavy duty stapler as well. This, I'm sure, it will not give up in the middle of the job and make a mess anyway. That will do. Hi, I made two or three other videos about making paintbrushes. The jumbo paintbrush was made with wood from window shutters. recycle from window shutters, the flat pieces. And another alternative source of handle wood is decaying plywood. I have videos showing both types. If you don't see any details in this video, check out the other ones. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.